See, I like Ayazo to move his head in between those shots, though. Not, you know, give free shots away. Because, you know, you don't want to give free shots away because it's you're set, you're allowing Johnson to catch a rhythm. And at the same time, you have a cut. So why do you want the guy to just tap away at that cut? You don't want that cut to get worse.
And you heard Johnson's corner, Israel Garcia, telling him, you need a box. Get after it. Less than a minute to go in the fight.
And with those good combinations, too. Left hooks, uppercuts, body shots.
Johnson is just a tough, tough dude. Eating shots, eating hooks, does not stop coming. And Gallardo trying to take him out. Johnson holding on. Deep breath from both fighters. Coliseo, Roberto Clemente here in San Juan, appreciating the fan, the fighters. Fans know what's up, man. This building's been fire for the last couple hours since we've been here. Our first bout here on Golden Boy Fight Night in Puerto Rico definitely delivers a hook from Gallardo. The 20-year-old gets some resistance, gets a bit tested, gets cut, but he lands some shots. He looks good. And hats off to Kevin Johnson. That is a tough, tough man.
Ladies and gentlemen, all three judges scores it 58-56. 58-56 and 58-56, the winner by unanimous decision. From Delicias, Chihuahua, Mexico, Jair Manota Gallardo.
Justin Ortiz has been known on the island as the upset guy. He comes in as the B-side, and he knocked your guy out. He's 4-0 with three KOs. And they wanted to test Jan Santana, the Dominican in black and gray, who's 8-0, all with KOs. An interesting game. Usually guys like this don't take fights.
Yeah, you know, when Justin, like you said, he's always comes in as the B-side and pulls the upset. And he's in a situation like that again. Yeah.
Santana, Miguel Cotto Promotions on his side. He's the house fighter. He's from the Dominican Republic. Lives here in Puerto Rico now. He said he's quick and fast and has some pop. That's the scouting report on him. And that Ortiz, just a heavy-handed young man who just swings and knocks you out. So we'll see how much boxing we actually get, Gabe, with this one scheduled for 6 rounds. Body work.
Oh, some good combinations from both guys.
Oh, the Dominican. Whoa. Oh, he's ready to go, and it's over.
It's over.
Oh, my goodness. Jan Santana, a first-round KO. He's 9-0, 9 KOs, and the Dominican shows he is on the rise.
Nice enough uppercut.
And Bully Chago's like, what are you doing? Asking him for more. Be careful, right? Why do fighters do that?
You know, he's really letting them know that, you know, that was a good one.
Okay. But.
You got me.
You do that?
Nah, man. Oh, that was a good counter.
You didn't acknowledge when your guy got you?
You just got to keep pushing. Everybody's different, you know? Yeah. That gets Carlos going.
In Acosta's last fight against Angelino Cordova, he was tentative and he lost. Very close fight. This wasn't his style there. This probably fits him better. Willing to trade, land his hooks, put Buitrago back, and moving Buitrago around. Buitrago trying to slip punches. Acosta won't let him off the ropes. Pushes him back against the rope. Tito Acosta, the former champ in San Juan. Chago is just tough, man. He's just so game.
Soltalo, soltalo, soltalo. Bring!
This is when you're in your 30s and you're savvy vet, huh? Mbui Trago put his hands out asking for more.
He felt that.
Oh, yes, he did.
That buckled him.
And he's talking while he's getting punched. And that'll do it for eight. Hope from Mbui Trago. And Mbui Trago's in a desperate mode. He's got to just unload this kitchen sink. He just winked at you. Beto's like right above us and he's winking at you. Look at it. He's right.
Beto's looking good, man. I like how he's posing the show. Doing good body shots.
That's a zone right there where you have a dude in the corner, you're hitting him, and he's looking at you with a wink and a smile. He did seem very confident yesterday. He said he had no problem. He said a chance to fight for another belt at 108 is why he came back down to the division. Fight is winding down. Acosta Mbui Trago. Go the distance.
Atención, damas y caballeros, aquí el resultado de este combate. Vamos para las tarjetas. Ladies and gentlemen, let's go to the scorecards. Judge Jose Roberto Torres and Idalia Parra scores it 99-91. Charlie Ruiz scores it 98-92 for the winner by unanimous decision from Del Barrio Obrero, Santurce, Puerto Rico, Angel Tito Acosta.
He actually apologized for not going to the fighter meetings. When I saw him, I was like, what happened? Well, I took a nap. He goes, because I just missed it, and I'm so sorry. He's like, do you need anything? I was like, no. Gabriel's out on eye. We got the research, though, but you know, appreciate the professionalism. The time
as
difference.
As a fighter, I understand.
Yep.
I understand. I used to hate the fighter meetings myself. Yeah.
But then as a broadcaster, you understand why they're so important.
Exactly.
Yeah, he said the time difference just he threw him off. The body shot.
Got him.
Ooh. Oh, I don't know if he's going to get up. He's rolling around. He does, but he is looking at Chepo like, ow, ow, ow. He popped up too, Gabe. The way he went down, I didn't think he would. 35 seconds to go in the round. Camacho with the body shot. He goes back in it, digging again. Oh, another one, and it's over. Oh, my. Juan Carlos Camacho Jr., a first-round KO of Jorge Orozco in Puerto Rico.
Devastating left hook to the body.
Orozco still down. The liver shots got him.
But yeah, he's just on top of Diago. He's not letting him breathe.
Pushing back the Filipino. Collazo sensing something. Big heart from Diagon. Uppercut from Collazo. A minute to go in the round.
Nice body shot.
Deep breath now from Diagon as he retreats.
The conditioning that Collazo has is amazing. You know,
he looks so fresh.
Not slowing down. It's like he's fresh. He's in his zone.
He's getting stronger as the fight progresses. Uppercut, hook from Diago. He's hurting as he goes back. Collazo stalking his prey. Does not let him stop. 10 seconds to go. Another round in the books for the champion.
Something's not right in this corner, but
He's definitely looking for a way out.
Are they going to stop it? Because the referees are talking.
He's looking for a way out. And
the fight is over. The fight is over. Oscar Collazo, for the first time in Puerto Rico as a champion, defends his belt, stopping the Filipino Gran Diagan.